Well, the new ship's out. Let's see what it costs. Now, in the interests of, you know, in this day and age, we're kind of in the social responsibility era where we not only have to take care of our own health, but the health of others. So I have to ask, is anybody at CIG, you know, entirely sure that Chris Roberts is okay? You know, sometimes people misread their medication and where it might say, it might say on the label, take one pill every 9 hours. Some people misread that and they take 9 pills every 1 hour or something like that. It could be time for like a wellness check is what I'm trying to say. Maybe just, you know, knock on the door and see what's up, because that price shocked the living crap out of me. Now, not in a bad way, in a good way, but still, when I saw that, I think a lot of us were kind of thinking alien ship, the alien tax, as it were. I was kind of seeing $250 minimum. So when I saw this, I went, oh my God. If this, you know, thank you. One, thank you, obviously, for the people who are going to buy this. Not myself, but we'll get into that in a moment. But to see something really cool like this, nearly flight ready, December 2020 is the expected release date, which, going by previous patch releases, January 2021 must be a little bit more realistic. December 2020 on the PTU. But it's a cool ship. It's a cool ship. I like it. I was digging through it and I was reading up on it. It seems like we got two variants. We got a missile variant and a gun variant, though when CIG gave us the spiel on the ship on Thursday, it was mostly dealing with the gun model. A little bit stealthy. It's a ship that's made to kind of get in real quick. It's got the potential to carry two big old size 4 guns on it, so get in quick, get some big hits in, and then dash away. Interesting idea. You know, it is kind of the glass cannon, and glass cannons do tend to work. You know, they do tend to hit pretty damn hard in some games, in others not so much. Now, it is a physically weak ship, not very well armored, not very well protected. You can see, like, when I was recording this as I was looking at it, and you can just see me like pause. Like, this footage is still rolling, just like, what? But yeah, it's a solid idea. It's a solid foundation for a ship to be laid upon. Now, will this work out in practice in the persistent universe? Depends on how physically weak that ship is. With turret improvements and things like that, I mean, you're not really looking at something that's going to be going up against large ships, but against other fighters. Let's say someone is distracted in, you know, something of a furball with a friend of yours, and then you come in real quick with this ship, get some devastating hits in there. It could be solid. It could be very solid as a fighter. Now, I would caution players to not really fall into kind of the fishbowl mentality, which some people get stuck into. And what I mean by that is, you know, oftentimes when you hear people talking about dogfighting and stuff like that, and they're kind of comparing ships, they're often thinking about it in an arena commander sense. And I don't just mean the idea that in space it's much bigger than like a 20-kilometer bubble that everyone is trapped in and they have to fight it out in. That is a factor, but not only that. You have to think about when you're flying a niche ship with a very niche application, having the right ship at the right place at the right time when you're in that niche, when your ship isn't much of a generalist but more of a very specific application, having the right ship at the right place at the right time is very, very difficult. We can idealize it and we can act like, oh yeah, that's always what it's going to be. But realistically, if you want to aim for that, then that's where you come into the thing of, you know, going like, okay, well now I'm going to have to think about tactics and I'm going to have to go beyond that. Maybe get a few other pilots who have the same ship, who want to do the same thing with me, who are reliable that I can count upon. Because you're probably going to have one or two ships running interference so that these guys can get in and get their hits. Because once again, it's potentially a very fragile ship. So it may, you know, it may deliver an unwelcome surprise to somebody. But it's also possible that if someone sees it coming in, they can deliver a much more unwelcome surprise to a ship that has very low survivability. So these are like realistic things to think about. I'm not, you know, sitting here going like, this ship was terrible, do not buy, you know, quote Minion Soldier 2020. No, what I'm saying is it's a very specific ship. So it's, you know, unless you're just buying it to have something that looks pretty in your hangar, with it is going to also come a bit of a responsibility on you as a player to kind of play in a certain way that really enhances what the ship has to offer. And you may have to realize that if you're sitting there and you're saying, this is the only fighter I'm ever going to own, you may find a lot of situations where that is going to be more of a hindrance than a help. Whereas a more generalist fighter design, yet there's the ejectable cockpit, a more generalist design may get you more mileage over time and, you know, may include a lot less little inconveniences, like, oh, what if I need to carry a couple extra guns or something like that. It's a cool ship, but $90 for an LTI fighter with a solid application, albeit niche, it for me personally, it's one of those things that I can definitely see it. I like that kind of Thunderbird design when you see it from above. But yeah, I can definitely see how it could be a very strong ship. Size 4 guns, are you kidding me? But overall, day in and day out, I don't know. For me, it's probably my personality, and I'm not going to make any kind of value statement about someone who would buy it. But if for me, as a pragmatist, I look at it and I go like, it's a cool idea. Definitely not shitting on the ship at all, but not for me. Now, speaking much more broadly of the ship production pipeline, we know that in 311, we're getting the Star Runner and we're getting the Origin 100 series of ships. That's kind of a given. We know that this now is coming out in December 2020, you know, possibly. But beyond that, we're not really sure what CIG is working on. I'm kind of thinking like a lot of the people who generally work in the ship pipeline are probably also doing a lot of polish work on Squadron 42. So I'm not, from my point of view, I know I love to make predictions about things, and I can't see, unless there's another, well, there's probably going to be another flight-ready ship coming out within the next year, probably too. So there's probably a couple of ships hiding out there. But I don't think that we're going to see any other real big hitters apart from the Hercules going into production anytime soon, unless, you know, surprise, surprise, they're all done for Squadron 42. So ship-wise, we may be coming into a bit of a lean year for a lot of the ships like the Corsair, the Polaris, things like that, that we've already pledged that we're still kind of waiting on. A while ago, we were seeing footage of the Orion, and we haven't heard a whisper about that in several months now. So chances are that is also off the table. We'll have to wait and see. Once again, it's a question of getting Squadron 42 out of the way. But who knows? We'll probably find out more on October 10th, and we'll probably get some more information in the future that can kind of give us a clearer idea of what's happening with the ship pipeline. But it almost, in a weird way, it almost looks like it's kind of, with this glut of work that's probably being done on Squadron 42, it almost looks like it's kind of closing up, which is weird. So you got to wonder what they're actually working on. It would be nice to be given some indications.
Thank you for watching. So if you want to keep up with the latest and greatest in Star Citizen and Squadron 42's development, please follow us on our social media channels. See you soon.